Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to record deposits in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. You need to record a deposit in QuickBooks if you receive a check from someone other than a customer. As we discussed in the How to Receive Payments lesson, customer payments are not entered as deposits. Click this link to access this course now. Some examples of the types of checks you might need to record as deposits are a refund check from a tax authority, a rebate check from a vendor, or an insurance claim check. To begin, from the home page, click on the plus sign at the top and select Bank Deposit right below the other column. This is the screen that we need to complete to enter a deposit into QuickBooks. In the first field, we need to select the bank account from the drop-down. So this will be the bank account that we want to make the deposit to. The date in this next field is the date that you will make the deposit. The date that appears here affects how the transaction shows up on your financial statements. Be sure to enter the date as close as possible to the actual deposit date. The balance here is the current balance in the bank account that we selected. In the Received From area, we want to go ahead and select from the drop-down the person or business that you received the check from. If you have not set up this person in QuickBooks, you can do so here by clicking the drop-down and selecting Add New. In the Account field, we want to select from the drop-down the account that we want to track this deposit in. In the Setting Up the Chart of Accounts lesson, we walk through step-by-step how to set up accounts. Click here to watch this lesson now. In the Description field, we want to type a description that will help you to identify what this check was for. In the next field, we want to go ahead and reflect the payment method. In this example, it'll be a check. In the Reference Number field, you want to enter the check number if the payment method was a check. Otherwise, you can leave this field blank. And then we'll go ahead and put in our deposit amount. You also have the ability to record cash back from a deposit. So here in this field, typically cash back, you will just put that to the petty cash account. You have the option to put a memo here if the petty cash was for a specific purpose. And then we can go ahead and enter the actual cash back amount that we plan to receive from this deposit. Once we do that, QuickBooks will reduce the deposit by the cash back amount to get our net deposit amount. And once you've completed all of the fields, we can go ahead and save and close this deposit. The next thing we want to do is review the deposit in the check register to make sure that everything was entered correctly. So back on the home page, you want to go ahead and select Transactions on the left-hand menu bar, and then Banking. We want to go ahead and click the Go To Register link on the right. And at the top, the most recent transactions will appear here. So at the very top, here is our deposit that we just entered from the IRS for the $75. If we needed to make any changes to this, all we would have to do is click here in any of the fields for this transaction, make our changes here, and then save them. Refer to the step-by-step written lesson to learn more about how your accounts and financial statements are affected when a deposit is recorded in QuickBooks. That wraps up the lesson on how to record deposits in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.